Push the thirst domino. Action trumps all. After successfully making it through 5 rounds of chemo and a bone marrow transplant, I unexpectedly hit rock bottom. I had gone to war with cancer twice in 3 years, and I had left everything that I had on the battlefield. I had fought for my life like a proud lion in the arena, cornered by a legion of bloodthirsty gladiators, but I came out victorious. But now that it was all over, I had nothing left to give. My armor was cracked. My body was broken. The initial reconstruction of my jaw had not been able to hold up against the gruesome ways of chemo eating away at the shoreline of what was once a perfectly balanced human face. The soft tissue harvested from my lower left leg that had been repurposed to serve as a jaw had rotten away and disappeared. The underlying metal plate that connected my chin to my right ear had broken in half. My trust in the surgeons who had performed my initial jaw amputation and reconstruction was down to 0. I no longer felt comfortable in their hands, as I felt like they had made many mistakes that could have been prevented. Much to the dismay of my own family, I informed my doctors that I would no longer be needing their services. Even though they were supposedly the absolute experts in my country when it came to facial surgery and reconstructions, I no longer wanted them to operate on me, even though I was walking around without a jaw and the broken metal plate of my face. I didn't know much, but I did know that I was done with them. I had been so focused on making it through my chemo that I had lost all sight of everything else. Tell me, where does the soldier go once the war is over? Home, I guess. Unfortunately for me, even though I still have my family and friends, I had completely lost any resemblance to the man I used to be. I found myself second-guessing if I had ever been that man in the first place. I would look at pictures and I wouldn't recognize the guy that was standing there. Had I made it all up? The confidence, the strength, the ambition? I looked within to try and find any remains of that man. I looked as long and as deep as I could, but in the end, I realized there was nothing there. Up until my decision not to continue working with my surgeons, I had always used future perspectives to keep my morale high. There was always a next step on the plan that allowed me to think short-term and focus on what was right in front of me. Now that I had fired the people who were in charge of putting together the plan, I was left with an enormous void. Even though I knew that I had made the right decision, I realized that it was now up to me to independently find someone else who would help me. When I went to flip that internal switch to yet again get it together and make a push to start my quest for a new surgeon, I found that that switch was no longer there. Even though I was still alive in the physical sense, the old me seemed to have died. The war against cancer had ripped out a part of me that I would never get back. I hung my head. For the first time since being diagnosed with cancer over 3 years ago, I gave up. I stayed in bed for hours, searching for a reason to get up and go through another day of pain and hopelessness. Every evening I would take my car, smoke a joint, and drive around listening to music, passing time. The marijuana made me numb and held me tightly in a soft blanket of temporary relief and comfort, while I listened to sad songs that helped me reminisce the life I used to live. I would close my eyes and see all the things that I had lost in the train wreck of these last 3 years. My girlfriend, my career, my strong body, my old face, my fearlessness. The memories would be so vivid and real that sometimes, if even for a brief moment, it felt as if I was there again, until I would once again open my eyes and see a broken face staring back at me in my rear view mirror. The tears would always come, sometimes soon, sometimes late. I would cry and ask why. This went on for a couple of months. I wallowed in self-pity and floated through the days. Until one morning in 2016, I woke up and I said, fuck this shit. This could not be the end of my movie. I wasn't even 30 yet. So much life left to live. I still didn't have the will or the energy to start looking for a surgeon who could help me, but I did feel some power for the first time in a long time. It was a start. I decided to start doing something useful with my time. Perhaps study something. During my time in Barcelona, I had taken up Spanish language classes, and I was already more than able to hold a basic Spanish conversation. I figured that it would be better to build on something that I had already put time and effort in, instead of starting something new from scratch. So I decided to enroll myself in a Spanish language course at an evening school for adults. For the first time in a long time, I actually had some place to be at a particular time. It felt good to have some type of structure again that wasn't linked to the gym. I was happy with my decision, but never in a million years could I have imagined the impact it would end up having on my life. Unknowingly, I had finally been able to push over that first domino. A life-changing chain reaction had been set in motion. While I was trying to learn new ways to call a South American woman beautiful in her native language. In my third class, I found my attention wavering, and it was hard for me to focus on what my teacher was saying. My stomach was still acting up from the chemo, and I had been on constant pain medication to ease the throbbing torment from the broken metal plate in my jaw. I started wondering what the use of these classes would be if I could not make the switch from a sick patient to a healthy man. As I was pondering, my negative thoughts were interrupted by my teacher's voice, announcing the end of class, urging us to practice at home and do our homework for next week. As I gathered my things to pack up and go home, I was approached by one of my classmates, a woman with whom earlier on I had done a dialogue exercise with. I hope you don't mind me asking, but could it be that you had to get a jaw amputation due to cancer? That's right. How did you know? People always assumed that I was in a bad motorcycle accident. Well, I happen to be a nurse, and just last week, I attended the seminar of this young up-and-coming surgeon who specializes in facial surgery and the removal of malign tumors through amputation. He gave a whole presentation on new ways to reconstruct different parts of the face. The cases he showed in his presentation looked very similar to yours. He left a huge impression on me, and I was curious to ask you if you might be working with him. Really? I have to admit that I've never heard of him. Would you perhaps mind writing down his name for me? Talk about a chain reaction. This surgeon would go on to be the man that turned my entire life around. My introduction to him was a pivotal moment in my uphill battle against cancer. He successfully operated on me, reconstructing a whole new jaw from my left oblique muscle and made my face complete again. Every single operation that he has ever done on me has turned out successful. I'm still working with him to this very day, as we are now working towards the placement of bottom teeth. Now, as beautiful as a story this may be, you must understand the overall point that I'm trying to make here. Not in a million years would I have expected to find the surgeon that would change my life when I signed up for my Spanish classes. But I did. You know why? Because I took action. We humans love this fantasy notion that we have absolute control over our destiny. If I just work hard enough, if I just try long enough, we consistently fall into the trap of believing that our life is this linear concept of cause and effect. It's not. Not even close. We attach way too much value to the goals that we choose to set. The actual plans that we make don't really matter that much. The important part is taking actual action and working towards something. It is by putting out a progressive signal into the world that we cause new doors to open up for us. When I do my YouTube live sessions and people ask me advice on how to improve their reality, I often tell them to join a gym. Does that mean that I believe that having bigger biceps will increase your chances of happiness? Absolutely not. I tell people that because by signing up to a gym, they might befriend a person who ends up being the sibling of their future partner. It's all about putting yourself in a position to get lucky. Not getting lucky as in getting laid, guys. I mean getting lucky as in allowing chance or the universe to shine down on you. You have to be in the proverbial mix if you want to have a chance to end up in a fortunate situation. I'm basically telling you that you can create your own luck by raising your odds. You can't hit the lottery without buying a ticket. You can't hit a home run if you're not in the game. The more action you take, the more movement you surround yourself with, the higher your chances of actually walking into a situation that could potentially change your life. You literally can't even get lucky by sitting at home, wallowing in self-pity. Nothing will happen until you start giving things a chance to happen. Ever since beating my cancers, I have lived a life that has been well above my means. I have traveled to some of the most amazing places in the world for long periods of time. People always wonder how on earth I'm able to do these things. Surely I can't be making that much money with my coaching, right? And we all know it's really hard to make any income from YouTube views. So, what's my secret here? It's simpler than you might think. I talk to people. I say hi to strangers. I smile. I make small talk. Because of this, I'm almost constantly making new friends. New friends equal new opportunities. I literally get invited to go and visit people in their countries all the time. They offer to host me and stay at their homes, so I don't even have to pay for a hotel. All I need is a plane ticket and I'm good to go. Talk about a million-dollar smile. Not bad for a guy with no bottom teeth. Over a decade ago, I was dating a girl that dumped me for being an obnoxious prick who would get way too drunk every chance he had. The breakup absolutely destroyed me. 21-year-old me thought I had just lost the love of my life. So I begged, I pleaded, I asked her what it would take for me to get another chance. She told me that I had to get my shit together and that getting a job, I was a student at the time, would mean a big step in the right direction. Even though I didn't need the money at the time, I immediately started looking for a job, as I figured it would give me another shot at dating her. I began working as a IT customer service agent a few weeks later. Did I get the girl back in the end? Mm-mm. However, I did meet my next girlfriend, whom I ended up dating for way longer than the one that had dumped me. She was my work colleague at the time, and I would never have moved on as quick as I did had I not taken action. No matter what the circumstances may be, positive action will always trump all. Not much will happen when you sit around and wait for things to change. You have to make things happen yourself. That's it, guys. That's the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to share it, hit the like button, and leave a comment. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, subscribe right now. Don't forget, if you want to hire me to work with me as a coach, you can do that right now. Just send me an email at lorenz.reese@gmail.com and we can get cracking right away. This video was based on the chapter of my upcoming book, Rotten Lemons. By the time that you're watching this video, it'll probably be out already. So check the description below if you want to buy my book and read up on my story and my philosophy. Thank you for watching, guys. I'll be back with more content soon. Boone is Viking, checking out.